Hey, what's up YouTube? I'm back again with another review. I've actually been meaning to do this review for quite some time now, though it looks like I'm actually about to sell this item, so I figured why not? Let's take a look at it before I do sell it. So today I'm going to be showing you guys the Toxicological Agents Protective suit. Here it is. Starting off with the mask, this is the M9A1. This particular model is from 1953. And I bought it in the sealed can. Here's the tap hood. It is double layered. It has the cord to cinch it up with. Now this one is from September 22nd, 1969. And then it's got the underarm straps, the metal hardware, the filter. Remember the M11 filters do contain asbestos, so I just leave the cap on there. Just to be safe. There's the carrier, size small, left side. Just a typical carrier. I think it still has the, and there's the anti-fog stuff. And then this, when I bought this lot off of eBay about 4 years ago, it was about five, it had come with the suit, two sets of over boots, and then the hood. Now these over boots I've never actually seen for sale anywhere else. I've never even seen them anywhere, but they're labeled M3 TAP over boots. So I'll show you. They're basically the poncho material with leg ties and then a canvas bottom, which I would assume the canvas is rubberized. So there's this pair. Let me try to show you guys a stamp on here. I know that the lighting isn't that great. These ones are from October 9th, 1959. And then here are the other ones. The canvas bottoms. It's hard to look with one hand. Looks like that one's all worn away. But the main part of the video is the suit. Now, taking a look at the bottom, you can see everything in here, everything that has metal hardware or anything like that has double like this. Waterproofed, rubberized, and then a leg snap to close up the ends here. Of course, thinking a real tap situation, all this would have been taped up anyway, so you really don't have to worry about that. Then you can see this double seam goes all the way up, takes us to the belt. I guess on most of these, the belts are missing, so I guess it's good that mine has it. Then it has the main closure, which you could tell that this one is from the 50s because it has the dish buttons. The zipper still works and is great. And then you go all the way up. Then it has a collar. The collar even has canvas adjusters. And then it has this weird part in front of it. So you actually climb inside of it. You don't put them on like normal coveralls because there's this thing that goes over your chest. And then there's the stamp. Size small, even though it fits me. 1961. And then the cuffs are doubled like that. Double snapped with charcoal padding to help soak up any chemicals should they go up your sleeve. And then let's try to flip it all the way around on the back here. So here's the back side of it. It's kind of gusseted like this. So like I said, when I originally got this suit, it was on eBay, It was all for about, I think after shipping, gosh, it was like, I want to say $50 or $60. It was an outrageously good deal. One that you will never find ever again. But yeah, guys, if you guys are interested in this, just let me know. I think I found a buyer. He said that he's willing to buy it, but you know, it's always an option out there. So if you guys have any questions about this stuff, I'll try to answer it the best of my ability. I don't actually know a whole lot about the tap system. I know that they had an apron, and then tap gloves, which looked to me, the picture that I saw looked just like the normal ones, but they could have been thicker, I guess. Also in the description, I'll leave a video to where you can see what these actually looked like while they're being used. So yeah, if you guys have any questions, like I said, just put them in the comments below. Like, comment, subscribe, and have a nice day.